अगली बार पीएम नहीं बनेंगे प्रधानमंत्री मनमोहन सिंह, उन्होंने ये साफ कर दिया। और साथ ही उन्होंने ये भी कहा है कि राहुल गांधी में क्षमता है प्रधानमंत्री बनने की, और उम्मीदवार कौन होगा लोकसभा चुनाव 2014 के लिए कांग्रेस की तरफ से पीएम का, इसका ऐलान सही वक्त पर कर दिया जाएगा। तो अगली बार पीएम नहीं बनेंगे मनमोहन सिंह। खुद मनमोहन सिंह ने आज की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में ये बात कही है। उन्होंने कहा है कि तीसरे टाइम पर प्रधानमंत्री की जिम्मेदारी सौंप दूंगा किसी और को, और ये बात उन्होंने साफ कर दिया है कि मैं अब अगली बार पीएम नहीं बनने जा रहा हूं। सीधे आपको फिर से लेकर चलते हैं प्रधानमंत्री की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में।
और कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स आई हैं जिसकी वजह से और चीजें को लागू नहीं किया जा सका, लेकिन जहां तक हमारे गवर्नमेंट का ताल्लुक है, स्कॉलरशिप्स फॉर माइनॉरिटीज हैव गॉन अप ट्रिमेंडसली, मौलाना आजाद फेलोशिप्स हैव इंक्रीज सब्सटेंशियली, एंड दी प्रोग्राम फॉर मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी अप्रोचेस टू माइनॉरिटी कंसेंट्रेटेड डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन 90 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ आवर कंट्री हैव बीन पुट इन प्लेस। So enough has been done, but I would be the last person to say that there is no scope for doing more.
The next question goes to the honorable representative of the Dainik Jagran newspaper, Mr. Raj Kishore. Right there, please.
प्रधानमंत्री जी नमस्कार, मैं राज किशोर हूं दैनिक जागरण से। मेरा प्रश्न है, पिछले 10 वर्षों में आप पर सबसे ज्यादा चुप रहने के आरोप लगे हैं। कांग्रेस पार्टी में भी यह कहा जाता रहा कि आप सही समय पर राजनीतिक जवाब नहीं देते हैं। आपको ऐसी क्या थी जो रोके रही 10 वर्षों में, और ऐसी कोई आपको ऐसी कोई कमी आपको लगती कि किसी वक्त पर आप बोलना था और आप वहां पर नहीं बोल सके?
जहां तक बोलने का सवाल है, जब भी जरूरत पड़ी है पार्टी फोरम में मैं जरूर बोलता रहा हूं और आगे भी बोलता रहूंगा।
The next question goes to the representative from the Hindustan Times, Mr. Shubhadra Chatterjee. If I get the name correctly, right there, please.
Sir, this is Shubhadra Chatterjee from Hindustan Times. Sir, with the elections due in barely 4 months, are you still hopeful about pushing some more reforms agenda? And if so, sir, what will be your priorities?
Well, reform is not an event, it is a process. And therefore, so long as we are in power, we will continue to push the cause of reform wherever there is scope for it, and if the circumstances permit to go forward.
The next question goes to the honorable representative of Times Now, Navika Kumar, please.
Sir, I'm Navika Kumar from Times Now, and my question to you is again related to corruption. You, time and again, every year, have written to your ministers to write down and submit to your office all their business interests so that decisions taken by them can be transparent. Now we see a similar example happening in a Congress-ruled state in Himachal Pradesh, Veerbhadra Singh, sitting in cabinet meetings deciding on issues that are related to a company when his family and he himself have business involvement with that company. Do you think that's proper?
I'm sorry, I'm not able to comment on what you're referring to happening in Himachal Pradesh. I have seen some newspapers reports. I've also received a letter on 29th of December by Shri Arun Jaitley, but I haven't had the time to apply my mind to it about what is the truth in these allegations.
The next question goes to the representative of NDTV Hindi, Mr. Himanshu Shekhar, please.
Prime Minister, sir, I had the privilege to attend your first conference after you became the Prime Minister. At that time, all of us had this perception that Manmohan Singh has a very clean image, a very non-political person has become the Prime Minister, an economist has become the Prime Minister with a good proven track record. 9.5 years later, how do you think an Aam Aadmi now perceives you as a politician, as a Prime Minister?
Well, I am the same person as I was 9 years ago. There has been no change. I say it with all sincerity that I have tried to serve this country with utmost dedication and commitment and with utmost integrity. I have never used my office to enrich or to reward my friends or my relatives.
The next question goes to the representative from the Washington Post. Lakshmi, please.
Mr. Prime Minister, I would like to ask you about the state of India-US relations now. This has been a big agenda in UPA-1 with the nuclear deal. But now as your term comes to an end, it looks like it has hit rock bottom again. Would you like to comment on that?
Well, our government attaches highest priority to strengthening the strategic partnership between our two countries. There have been recently some hiccups, but I sincerely believe that these are temporary aberrations and diplomacy should be given a chance to resolve these issues that have arisen.
Next question goes to the representative from the DY365, Rama Sharma.
Thank you, sir. So my question is that difficult terrain has become a very common region by those government implementation, project implementation agency in the Northeast, whether it is the border incomplete Indo-Bangladesh border, border issue or incomplete Silchar Lamling Board Conference railway project. So what is the thing that your government has ever tried to overcome this difficult terrain issue?
I have not understood.
Difficult terrain is always a common phrase for the government project implementation agency in the Northeast.
What she's saying?
Terrain, yeah.
Difficult terrain.
Whether it is incomplete border issue?
Last mile.
Well,
incomplete fencing of the border issue?
Well, that's very true. I mean, if you're talking about fencing of the border.
Yeah, and the incomplete other project also in the Assam or Northeast.
I think fencing and other, some of these other projects have been facing some difficulties because of difficulties of terrain. There is no doubt about that.
Sir, can I ask one more question regarding the animals distinct, rhino killing, sir? Very important for us. Sir, rhino killings has become rampant in Assam. Assam government raised forest guard, forest battalion to stop this, but still this is going on. Do you feel central government should step in to protect the rhino?
Rhino is a national asset. Every effort should be made and will be made to protect this precious animal.
The next question goes to Mr. Alok Mehta, please.
Pradhan Mantri ji, आपने चूंकि एक बड़ा लंबा अरसा देखा है प्रधानमंत्री के रूप में भी, वित्त मंत्री के रूप में, अपोजिशन लीडर के रूप में, और अब जिस तरह से इलेक्शन हो रहे हैं, एक लीडर्स के नाम पर ही वोट चुकी है, आपकी पार्टी भी तय कर रही है कि पहले प्रधानमंत्री का नाम तय हो जाए, तो आपको लगता है कि हमारे सिस्टम में भी कभी मतलब पार्लियामेंट को विचार करना होगा कि कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में चेंज करके प्रेसिडेंशियल सिस्टम होना चाहिए ताकि गठबंधन की राजनीति में जिस तरह दिक्कतें आपको आई होंगी या दबाव आए होंगे देश के विदेश के, उससे निपटने में अगले नेतृत्व को लीडरशिप को सुविधा हो?
I haven't thought through this question in any depth, but it is my preliminary reaction that the parliamentary system of government is the best suited for a country of India's complexity, of India's diversity, that a presidential type of system would be counterproductive.
Next question goes to the representative from NDTV English, Mr. Sunil Prabhu.
Mr. Prime Minister, sir, you know, my question is very simple and straightforward on the issue. I know there have been a lot of questions on corruption, on various other issues, but personally for you, many will accuse you, as you said, history has to be kind and look at you and you'll come out unscathed, but many will look at you personally as being unable to actually act or rein in your own cabinet ministers. The fact that you allowed a situation to go out of hand, that you failed to act politically, which was required, and that you kept going back to a core group or to various other people but refused to act, and that is why we came to a stage where even the Supreme Court asked the Prime Minister's office and even indicted it for various acts of omission and commission. So how do you respond to that politically, and how do you see your legacy because of the failure of you to act in a
well, I honestly believe that history will be kinder to me than the contemporary media or the power, or for that matter, the opposition parties in parliament.
But about the fact that you
came
to act personally,
I cannot divulge all the things that take place in the cabinet system of government. I think taking into account the circumstances and the compulsion of a coalition polity, I have done as best as I could do under the circumstance.
The representative from Zee News, please.
Thank you, Manish ji. प्रधानमंत्री जी, सबसे पहले आपका धन्यवाद कि मुझे ये सवाल पूछने का मौका मिला. मैं आपको जी मीडिया के एक नेशनल चैनल और 8 रीजनल चैनल के 200 मिलियन व्यूवर्स की तरफ से एक सवाल पूछना चाहता हूं कि जब आप कहते हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री के तौर पर आपका जो है कार्यकाल अब आप पूरा करने जा रहे हैं और बैठन आप राहुल गांधी आप इंडिकेट कर रहे हैं, मेरा सवाल आपसे यह है कि जब मुकाबला होगा तो राहुल गांधी वर्सेस नरेंद्र मोदी का मुकाबला होता है, नेचुरली आप राहुल गांधी के साथ होंगे क्योंकि आपकी पार्टी है, लेकिन क्या आप मानते हैं कि मुकाबला बराबरी का होगा और 2014 में वाकई आप राहुल गांधी के नेतृत्व में सरकार बना पाएंगे या आपको विपक्ष बैठना पड़ेगा? थैंक यू वेरी मच.
आई हैव फुल कॉन्फिडेंस दैट द नेक्स्ट प्राइम मिनिस्टर विल बी फ्रॉम द यूपीए कोलिशन एंड दैट विदाउट डिस्कसिंग द मेरिट्स ऑफ Mr. Narendra Modi, I sincerely believe that it would be disastrous for the country to have Narendra Modi as the Prime Minister.
The next question goes to the representative from the Indian Express, Mr. Manish Chhibbar, if he's here, please.
Yeah, right here. Hello, sir. Manish Chhibbar from Indian Express. Sir, the BJP and Mr. Modi's, charge against you is that you have been a weak prime minister. So do you think, your party has a role to play in that projection of this view?
Well, I do not believe that I have been a weak prime minister. That is for the historians to judge. And the BJP and its associates may say whatever they like, but if by strong prime minister you mean that you preside over the mass massacre of innocent citizens in the streets of Ahmedabad, that is the measure of strength. I do not believe that sort of strength this country needs, least of all in its prime minister.